So, hello students, this is the history of standard 6 and this is the chapter 5 and it is the very first lecture, that means lecture 1. Today we will see about the Vedas and other sources. This is the chapter 5. So before starting this chapter, we will start this chapter with a positive thoughts. That is the mistake as proof that you are trying. What it is? Mistake as proof. This is the proof that you are trying. If you are doing something and if you are making mistake, that means you are doing something, you are trying. And if you will not do anything, you will not face any type of problem, you will not make mistake. So don't afraid to make mistake. Mistakes, from mistake you will learn, and from that learning you will assist your future to achieve something that you want to do. So attempt the new thing, take risk, learn and do mistake. No worries. If you are doing mistake, no worries. It's proof that you are doing and trying. So keep doing the things and don't afraid for the mistakes, because the positive things in this negative world, that means in mistake, is that you are learning, and from that learning you can assist your future. So let's start this chapter. So before starting this chapter, I want to connect the time period in history through which we can go in a chronological order, that means in a sequence order. So as we have seen in the previous chapter, in the chapter 1 or in chapter 2, about the stone age. That was the, I think in that age the we have seen about the we have learned about the early man, and the time period of that early man was 2 million BC to 3500 BC, and in this duration they learn a lot, they develop themselves, and they go through three phases. That was the Paleolithic age, that was from 2 million BC to 10,000 BC, and that was second was the Mesolithic age, that was from 10,000 BC to 8,000 BC, and then we have learned about the Neolithic age, in which the people used to live a settled life. They started to grow their own crops. That was the Neolithic age, that was existed around 8,000 BC to 3500 BC. After this age, the people came into the another development, came into the next stages of their life. That was the 3500 BC to, in which the people came into the Chalcolithic age. That was, I have told you in the previous chapter, that was in which in this age they were aware from the copper, and they used copper and stone both together to make their tools, and gradually they improved themselves, and they were aware from the metallurgy process, and they used to mix the bronze, copper and tin to make the bronze, and from bronze they also used the bronze widely, and they make tools from the bronze. And in these bronzes the urban civilization developed, that was the Indus Valley civilization, that was existed around 2700 BC to 1900 BC, in which in these age the Indus Valley civilization was flourished. And as you have you know that this was a urban civilization and the great civilization of our India. But from 1900 BC, that means after the Indus Valley civilization, from the 1900 BC to 1500 BC, the archaeologists have not found any type of activity or any type of information. That's why this age is came to be called the Dark Age, because nothing they have found from of this period. Then after, the people were coming in the another stage of life, another development of their life, that was the Vedic Age, that was started from 1500 BC to 500 BC. In Vedic Age, in this period people learn about writing. So in Vedic age people came into the next stage of their life, that means in the another development. So In this period, the people were settled near the north western part of the subcontinent that were extended up to the Afghanistan. So these people first called themselves Aryans. Aryans is the word. This word, that means the Aryan, taken from the Sanskrit word Aryas. Aryas mean the pure, the honorable, the warrior. At first, the Aryans were settled in the northwest part. So they came. They called these places as the Sapt-Sindhu. They called that place where they first settled, that region were called Sapt-Sindhu. So Sapt-Sindhu, from this word, you can say this is the word of this is the word of Sapt. This word is made from the word Sapt and Sindhu. So Sapt means seven and Sindhu, that you have already learned about, that Sindhu is the Indus river. So it is the Sapt-Sindhu means the land of seven river. Here the river Indus and with the tributaries river. So this area around this river is called the Sapt-Sindhu region. So in which the tributaries of the Indus river were followed Satudri, that is called the Satluj. That is called Satluj today. Parushni, that is the Ravi river. Vipasha, that is the Bias river. That is the oldest name, old name, and that is the recent name. That means the current name. And the Askini, that is the Chenab. Vitasta, that is the Jhelum. And the Saraswati river, which is dry today. And the Indus, that means the Sindhu river. So all these rivers were flowed in the northwest region, and that place was called the Sapt-Sindhu region. So it is still not very clear that to where exactly they came from. Some archaeologists or scholars said that they came from the European country, or some said they came from the Central Asia. So the Vedas, most of the information that we have about the Aryans came from the Vedas. The Vedas are the set of four books or four Veda, that is the Rig Veda, Sam Veda, Yajur Veda and Atharv Veda. So this is the four book, and together it is called the Vedas. This age is came to be called Vedic age just because all the four Vedas were written during this period. And Vedic age is further divided into two ages, that was the early Vedic age and the later Vedic age. In early Vedic age, before the early Vedic age, we will see about the Rig Veda, which is a very ancient book in our history. It is the oldest book of in our history. So Rig Veda give us a lot of information about the Aryans. It is the oldest book in the history, and also it was written before the these three Vedas. It is oldest in these four Vedas. It consists of lot of hymns. Hymns or Sukta. It is hymns or Sukta means the well said. So hymns means the religious poem or religious song that were specially written for the purpose of praise, adoration or prayer, typically addressed to the deity and deities. Deity and deities means the god and goddesses. So Rig Veda is the oldest book. It was just composed at that time and not written, because they were not aware from the script. So just they composed, and this was written after many years. It was it was written down by hand. That means it was in the form of manuscript. As I have told you in the previous chapter about the manuscript, when the paper, when paper was not invented, people used to write on a paper like material like the papyrus or the bark of the trees. So after many years the Rig Veda were written, but at that time when it was composed, the scholars of that time were used to memorized the hymns of the Rig Veda, and then they taught to their students, and after then the students taught others. That's as like that the hymns or anything which was in the Rig Veda were passed on from person to person, from one generation to another generation. So let's see about a brief explanation of early Vedic age. So early Vedic age is the time period of early Vedic age is 1500 BC to 1000 BC. In these age the Rig Veda was written. So we have lots of information regarding the early Vedic age, and early Vedic age is also called the early Rig Vedic age, just because in these age the Rig Veda was written. So according to the information that we have got from the Rig Veda, that is in this period the people were living in a tribal society. That means they have a small villages, and the group of that societies were called the Jan or Vish, and the head of the Jan or Vish was the Raja. And Raja they chosen the Raja from amongst themselves. That Raja would have the ability to rule or to lead in their society. But there was not any hereditary system, like if someone is Raja. Suppose someone is Raja, then in hereditary system, the son of that, that Raja would die, then son have the authority to rule. But in that time, that means in early Vedic age, this was not there. There was not the system of hereditary. Now, cow is very important part of the society. The person who have owned large number of cow considered as the prosperous, important and wealthier person in the society. Even they fought war for acquiring more and more cow. Now let's see about the occupation. In society they consist of traders, warriors, priests and some other people that were involved in agriculture, rearing of animals. But there was not any strict restrictions, like if someone is doing the work of the agriculture, then the son would have to do that work only. No, there was not any undue pressure on anybody to pursue their ancestor occupation. If they want they can do some other things if they are interested in other things. So they were free to do any kind of occupation, and also they were free to interact with each other. So there was not any type of caste system or religious system, so they interact freely with each other. In the early Vedic age, people also worshipped some gods like the Agni, the god of fire, the Indra, the god of thunder, and the Varuna, that was the god of wind and water. And the Raja also performed some small rituals and sacrifices, because they have believed that if they will do that type of ritual and sacrifice, they can secure their society. So the people believe that if the god were kept happy, they would not let any harm come to their life. So here we will finish this chapter, this lecture, and in next lecture we will see about the later Vedic age. Thank you.